This morning in pet care, we are discussing the importance of spaying and neutering, particularly because there are an overabundance of kittens waiting in shelters and rescues, of course, throughout Rhode Island and, of course, beyond. But here now, to focus things on the Ocean State, we have, to tell us more, Giana Tortolani from Community Care Center in Johnston. Good morning, Giana.
Hi.
These guys are so adorable. We met them at the beginning of the show. And who do you have here assisting you hold one of the other kitties?
So this is our director, Diane.
Great. We appreciate the effort, because if I held one of them, it probably wouldn't. And well, look at us out here in front of the gazebo. It's like a Norman Rockwell painting, isn't it? Right here. But that's not why we've invited you here. Let's talk about what we need to know, because this is a very important issue out there. Opening with trap neuter release. What is that, and what do the folks need
to
know?
So there is such an overpopulation problem with cats right now in the state. Community cats, feral cats just roaming the streets that are hungry, that need our help. So trap neuter release is the most effective way to really get these cats hopefully into homes, and if not, just to we trap them, neuter, spay them, and then release them back into their outdoor communities.
It really is so crucial. It is so vital that the people out there, the community at large, that they do their part to help control that pet population. Because, you know, the last thing we want, you know, are these guys, you know, to meet an untimely end or something like that. And by doing that, by controlling it, we can help out, right?
Exactly. Yeah. So at Paws Watch, we're so blessed and thankful to have the volunteers that we have. But we really, really do need more people to know, step up from their communities and help us trap. We can teach you how to trap. We have all the tools that are necessary, and just come out and volunteer and help, come play with the kittens. We have a whole kitten room set up that you can come and see us at.
Yeah, what a great opportunity, you know, if you're thinking about adopting, and just come down, see you guys. And I would imagine that you will work with people to see who's a good fit, because we want it to be the right fit for the cat.
Of course, you can come in and apply. And we do, we are looking for vets to help us out and with neutering and just giving them the vaccinations and just to help out the sick kitties in the state.
What are the names here? What do we need
to know? So this is Callahan, and then this is Dorothy.
And who named them?
I think whoever trapped them named them for the most part. That's how it works. If you trap it, you get to name it as well.
Very cute. Now, are you a lifelong cat person?
Yeah, so I've had cats all my life. I have 3 cats at home and 2 foster kittens right now.
And
so
I would imagine
5.
That fostering is so rewarding for you.
Yes, it's amazing. It's amazing. So it really helps just to socialize the kittens and, you know, get them ready for their adoption.
And it really is crucial that we continue to create awareness, that we continue to get the word out there to do this type of thing. You know, I Will and I talk about him all the time on the show. Yeah. I learned a great deal about cat rescue and fostering through Howard Stern and his wife Beth.
Yes.
They do this constantly.
Yeah. Oh my God,
it really is
Stern.
Amazing what she's doing, you know, through that.
Yes.
You know, maybe it takes somebody famous to put the spotlight on this, to let people know that they can help and that they can do something, right?
Yeah, I honestly didn't. I mean, I've had cats all my life, and I didn't even realize to the extent of the problem until I started volunteering with Diane. It's crazy. We started trapping a colony of over 30 cats last week, and we got 9 in one day.
Oh my goodness.
So there's definitely a need out there.
And look at that face. I mean, look how cute. I mean, I made jokes at the top of the show about the cats that live next door hating me at my house, but that's not true. They are lovely, and they do ultimately, I feel like they do want to love you.
Oh yes. No, they are very, very lovable animals.
And
just need to find the right home.
Anything that people need to know in terms of contacting you?
So we are on Putnam Pike in Johnston. So, and then I guess our website will be listed at the end.
Wonderful. Yeah, we will have that on our website as well. Well, ladies, we can't thank you enough for joining us.
Thank you for having us.
These guys are adorable. And if you guys would like to learn even more or to review this segment one more time, we will have more information on how you can be involved, what you can really do to do your part at roadshow.com.